And now we're going to present a method for making HAR features, which are already computationally very efficient, even more efficient. And that's by using what are called integral images. So let's first take a look at what an integral image is. So let's assume that this is our image given to us, and this is the integral image. So the integral image, if you look at the brightness value stored at any pixel in the integral image, say this pixel right here, all it is the sum of all the pixels above it and to the left of it, including itself. So that's this rectangle right here. And if you look at this value right here in the integral image, and we're going to depict that with II, where I is the image, II is the integral image, this value is the sum of all the pixels in this window right here. Okay, that's the integral image. And we'll discuss how we can compute the integral image very quickly. Given an image with a single pass, you can compute the integral image. But for now, let's just assume it's given to us. So then, if you wanted to find the sum of the brightnesses of pixels within a window, a rectangle, like this, how do we do that? Well, it's very simple. You're going to take this value right here. That's going to give you the sum of intensities in this window. And then you're going to subtract from that this value, which is the sum of intensities in this window. And you're going to subtract this value, which is the sum of intensities in this window right here. And now you notice that this little window here has been subtracted twice, and so you add that back in by using this value. So just with three additions, you're able to compute the sum of intensities within this rectangle right here. And the interesting thing to note here is that this cost is independent of the size of the rectangle. That's what's interesting about the integral image. So now let's talk about the HAR filter, or one HAR filter. Let's say it's the simple one, this one right here, where you have a white region and a black region. What do you do in this case? Well, let's treat it as two different rectangles. So for this rectangle right here, this one, we're going to need these four pixel values. And for this rectangle, we're going to need these four pixel values. So remember that the final result is the sum of intensities in the white region minus the sum of intensities in the black region. Sum of intensities in the white region is given by these four values in the integral image. Sum of intensities in the black region is computed using these four values. And if you look at the whole thing, you see that all you need is seven additions to compute this filter. Now, of course, the filters can get more sophisticated. They may have more black and white regions, and therefore, you may need more computations. But really, the power of the integral image comes from the fact that it's independent of the size of the filter that you're applying. So the last thing to discuss is, how do we compute an integral image given an image? It's actually very simple. You do it in a raster scan fashion, a single scan of the image. You go from the top left corner and you scan the image, and at each pixel, pixel A, we can compute the value of the integral image at that pixel using just the values above it, diagonally, before it, and the value to the left of it. So C, B, and D. Because those have already been computed, because that's how you ended up getting to the pixel A. So the value at pixel A is the value at pixel B, which we know includes is the sum of intensities in this rectangle right here, plus the value at pixel C, which is the sum of intensities in this rectangle right here. That means that this one right here, this rectangle, has been added one too many times, and so you subtract D, the integral image value at D, thereby removing, subtracting the sum of intensities in this rectangle right here. And that's it. You keep doing this for every pixel, and you end up with your integral image, and then that can be used to compute your HAR features. So that's how the HAR features are computed then. The integral image needs to be computed only once for any new image, very fast. And then you can compute all your har features and you get a vector here. This will be a feature vector that we'll use for classification purposes. If you're interested in multiple scales, we will apply classification to multiple features for each pixel.